This is one of the first boots of the AVR board. Had a little trouble with the backlight. Did switch to a different part. It's a little bit more readily available from Mauser. It's still a non-semiconductor part. If you'll notice, the backlight's nice and crisp. I'll flick it on and off here again so you can see. Nice and crisp. It's about 20 volts, 40 milliamps power to the LCD backlight. The backlight controller actually works all the way down, you know, well below 6 volts, which is way less than what the AVR can handle. I am reworking some of this board, but basically this is it. This is actually a board that I had probably a year ago that I never was able to actually get to work. The issue ended up being, after populating the backlight controller with a new part, which is somewhat untested, there were a couple of people trying to use it on the homebrew page. I simply couldn't get it to work, and I couldn't figure out why. So I basically connected an LED string up to this point here. There's an anode and cathode connect point here. And I was able to get it work from the get-go. This connector I purchased, I believe, from Mauser, and they had a couple of different styles. The connector is actually, you may get 4 or 5 insertions. This particular connector, I've probably done 20 insertions, and it just doesn't work anymore. The only real way that I can recommend fixing is actually to replace the connector, but in a pinch, if you suspect the connector, the best thing to do is actually pry this down and actually take something like a relatively soft screwdriver and actually press down. Obviously the backlight connections are right in this area. If you'll actually just kind of crease this with a tool, eventually it'll connect. It won't stay that way, but at least you can verify and test. The better connectors, this is a wedge style connector, and I'll take it off here so you can see. This is actually a inverted wedge style connector. So the connection point actually goes above this point here and slides into this groove. The issue is, I'm not really sure whether you can see it, but if you look real careful, you can see how this is starting to deform. This probably is designed for a cable much thinner than what this actually is. But like I say, it doesn't really work well. There are better options out there. The best type of cable connector for this application is usually one that actually clamps inward. In other words, you'll actually, instead of this being a wedge and flopping up and down, the wet, it will actually compress it by pushing inward. This will actually press in. The connector's a little bit larger. It may be, you know, 50 cent more, but all around it'll accept a lot more connections. It's a lot more reliable. Anyway, this is one of my combo boards that I'm bringing up. This is the second one that I've done. Basically, I had built one, purchased one that someone else had started building, and kind of put it to the side, and I'm revisiting it now to maybe update and rework some of the components on the board. I've got a lot done on this already as far as replacing this. It's STM32. It's got the new Chrome Art processor, and basically it's very similar to the STM32 disco board. With the exception of, obviously, I'm using a larger LCD. I do plan on still using this style and size LCD, along with a couple of OLED displays to attach at the individual controllers. Anyway,